Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, what is glycemic index? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. As a person with diabetes, there are certain terms and tools we all need to know about in order to help keep our blood sugar under control. One of those tools is the glycemic index. The glycemic index, or GI, measures how foods raise blood glucose. These foods are then ranked on a comparison with a reference food. The reference food is pure glucose with a GI of 100. The glycemic index is basically a scale of 0 to 100 with higher values given to foods that cause the more rapid rise in your blood sugar. Now, the glycemic index values are determined experimentally. Foods are eaten by test subjects, and then blood samples are taken at different intervals. Now, the inventor of the glycemic index is Dr. David Jenkins. He and some associates at St. Michael's Hospital in Toronto, Canada, performed the earliest studies on this subject. There's been an effort more recently to update the GI by Jenny Brand Miller and her associates at the Human Nutrition Unit of the University of Sydney in Australia. A 2016 study by Brigham and Women's Hospital found that individuals who eat many high GI foods are more than twice as likely to develop diabetes. It is believed that the high insulin demand generated eventually can exhaust the pancreas, leading to the onset of the disease. Additional evidence suggests that the lower GI intake may aid in weight control. One study found that overweight teenagers who ate low GI breakfast foods were less hungry and ate 45% fewer calories during the day than those who did so after eating a high GI breakfast. And further research indicates that low GI foods may provide a weight loss advantage over high GI foods even when the caloric intakes are equal. Now, the theory behind the glycemic index is simply to minimize insulin-related problems by identifying and avoiding foods that have the greatest impact on your blood sugar. When looking at the GI number, those that are 55 or less are considered low. Those with a GI of between 55 and 70 are medium, and anything over 70 is high. The GI is a good tool for deciding what foods or how much of a food to eat, and there are many charts and books with the GI of hundreds of foods in them. Of note, I personally feel the glycemic index is a great tool, but the glycemic load is an improvement on the GI. And you can look for our video, What is Glycemic Load, for a more detailed explanation. Well, I hope this answers your question, what is the glycemic index? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, if you have any other diabetes-related questions, feel free to let me know. Thanks for watching. I'm Ty Mason.